Let's look at the Python zip function. Here we've got two lists, lows and ups, and we've got a dictionary called adict, and we've got a for loop that uses the two lists to create a dictionary. So when we print that, we've got lowercase letters and the uppercase letters in a dictionary. Now one way we could change this is to use zip. So we don't need the for loop, and the dictionary, we're going to make that equal when we want the dictionary, and that's the type we want, and we want to zip the lows and the ups. So now when we print a dictionary, we have the same dictionary as we did before using zip. Now we might not necessarily want a dictionary, we might just want to look at the values, so we can use a for loop, for example. So for L and U in zip lows and ups, we can print L and U. Let's just put the colon in there. So we can print that, and you can see we now have our lowercase letters and uppercase letters printed. Now we can see what type zip is. If we just create a variable called azip equals zip lows and ups, and then we can print the type of azip, you can see we have class zip. So if we want to put this into a list, for example, we could say print and then list of azip, and now if we print that, we've got class zip, what's azip. But when we print it, you can see we've now got the letters lowercase and uppercase A, B, C, D. They are in tuples inside a list. We can even change the lists so they are tuples. So let's change the brackets. So now our lists are not lists, they are tuples. We can still use zip. And when we print type, you'll see it's still zip, and we can print the azip at the end, and you'll see the class is still zip, and we have tuples rather than lists, so we have a tuple of tuples. Now we can check to see if zip works with strings, so let's just try two simple strings, hello and world. And then we're going to zip them, and we can see when we use a for loop, we have each of the letters of the strings. We can add some values to one of the lists, and you'll see that it won't make any difference because the zip function creates the zip object on the smallest amount within one of the lists or tuples. So when we run this, you'll see that our and the E and F, they remain not in the final results. So we don't have any pair with E and F. So we start from the left, and the pair of A's, B's, C's and D's are matched. Now if you did want to put something in, there is the fill value, equals, and we could add, what could we add here? So let's say we had a value of 0, for example. Now we need to change zip to zip longest, which we can import from iter tools. So we have zip longest, and now when we run this, we can see, oh, we spelled that wrong. Zip longest, we have our E and F included with our fill value of 0. So you can see there, we have run that with the class zip longest rather than zip. Now let's go back to our original code, and we have our A, B, C and D. Let's make that a list, so we can change our low to a list and our up to a list, and we can go back to our zip, and we can see when we go back to our list in our print, we can print, and that's back to our list of tuples. Now what we can do is we can have a third, or we can have two or many lists or tuples that will be paired together using zip. So for example, we could have numbers, and we've got lows, ups and number, and then we can print that, and you can see now we've got AA1, BB2, CC3, DD4. So we can use 2, 3, 4, any amount that we want. So we're not just zipping pairs, we're zipping values together. In our last example, we're just going to show how you can reverse the action using zip, but something else called argument unpacking, which we're not going to go into detail here, but you can see this list of tuples called letters. We're going to use zip and the asterisks with letters, and then print the result. We can see we have our ABCD and ABCD uppercase in tuples, strings in tuples. Let's look at our practice exercises. Exercise 1, zip 2 lists. Exercise 2, zip 2 tuples. Exercise 3, zip 2 lists into a dictionary. Exercise 4, print each pair of values in 2 lists using zip. And finally, exercise 5, zip 3 lists. And here are the solutions. Exercise 1, you can see we have 2 lists here, and we're just going to make answer equals zip A and B list and print that as a list. So that's exercise 1. We can look for exercise 2. We zip 2 tuples, which is the same except we use round brackets, and when we print it we say tuple. There's our printed out answer. Now exercise 3, we want a list to a dictionary. So we've got our 2 lists, we've got answer equals, and we put DICT, so we change it to a dictionary. When we zip the 2 lists, we print that, you can see we have our dictionary. So now if we move on to exercise 4, have the 2 lists again, we've got a for loop, so we zip the lists, and we've got A and B, we just print them for exercise 4, which is quite straightforward. So you can see there, 1 to 6, A to F. And finally, we go on to exercise 5. Now we've got 3 lists, A list, B list, and C list. We answer equals zip, A list, B list, C list, and we print that as a list. And if we run that, you can see we've got the tuples of 3 values all in the list. Okay, if you're interested in learning program, then please subscribe and hit that bell to get notifications of all videos that will be released.